बार आ रहे डिस्कनेक्ट बहुत। Okay, good afternoon to you all. Today we are going to learn about measurement of angles of polygon, where let's talk about polygon as first. So if we talk about polygon, we can define it like this here. A closed figure formed by three or more than three line segments is called polygon. Okay, that means all the figures which is formed by using three or more than three line segments, such all the figures are considered as polygon, where giving the examples of polygon, we can suppose triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon, etc. But from the given polygon, either the polygon may be regular or irregular, two type of polygon. That means there are two type of polygon, either the polygon are regular or irregulars. Okay, so that here, now we are going to talk about the type of polygons, where as first we have the regular polygon. As per the formation of polygon, the first one is regular polygon. The polygon having all the dimension equal is called regular polygon, as given to you on your screen, or you can see on your screen that in the first, there is given the triangle ABC, where all the sides are given equal to us here, or we can see on our screen here. In the given triangle, all the sides are equal. In the same way, it's what here, look here, it's all the angles are also equal. That's why such type of figure having all the sides or all the angles are equal, such type of figures are considered as regular polygon, regular polygons. In the same way, in the second, you can see here, there is a picture of a square where all the sides are equal. In the same way, all the angles are also equal, which are indicated by the red symbol. Okay, angles are indicated by the red symbol. Okay, which indicates it's all the angles are equal. Okay, so that a square is also considered as regular polygon. In the same way, here you can see a pentagon on your screen, that where the angles of pentagons are indicated by the yellow sign. You can see here yellow sign where the sides are indicated as equality. Okay, that's why whatever the given figure, but if they have the equal measurement of side and angle, on that time we should consider as the given figure is a regular polygon. Remind it. In the same way, if we talk about irregular polygon, we can define it just opposite to the regular. That is here, the polygon which does not have all sides equal is called irregular polygons. Okay, that means it is not considered as the equality. That means what? Here we have a given triangle on our screen. That in the first, as we have given a triangle where or of which all the sides are not equal. That means this is longer than this one part, where this one is longer than this one part. In the same way, you can see the second picture, that is a rhombus, where the both sides are equal, but the both sides are not equal. That means to be of regular polygon, we don't need any two or any three sides are equal or angles are equal. We need to have all the sides and all the angles are equal. Okay. Until the given figure doesn't having the all the sides are equal and angles are equal, until we can call the given figures are regular polygon. In the same way, we have here, after that, we are going to talk about the interior and exterior angle of polygon. So that let's talk about the interior angle of polygon. For that, we have given a figure. You can see on the screen that there is, in the given figure, angle ABC here, you can see ABC here, ABC here, you can see here ABC, that means this angle ABC, and BCA, that means BCA, that means this angle. In the same way, BAC, BAC, that means the angle like this here, BAC, this angle, our interior angle, where angle ACD is an exterior angle. In this way, we can identify the interior and exterior angle, where while identifying an exterior angle, the angle which is given out of the figure, that is, look here, the green figure, this blue figure is considering as the exterior angle, that is ACD, the angle ACD. This angle is considering as the exterior angle of the given figure. So I hope you will classify or identify the interior angle or exterior angle from the given figure. In the same way, here we have a formula to find its interior angle of a regular polygon is equal to n minus 2 into 180 degree by n, where n is equal to number of sides of regular polygon. That means n indicates the number of side of regular polygon. This n indicates the number of side of regular polygon. So if the figure is given of the regular polygon, on that time only we can apply the formula to find the each interior angle of regular of the given polygon. Then after we have the sum of interior angles of a polygon. As you have learned in your previous class about the formulas given to us to find the sum of interior angles of a polygon, where first we have given D1, the sum of interior angle of a polygon in the given regular triangle. The triangle is a regular polygon. That's why we can call it regular triangle, because all the sides of the triangles are equal, okay, or indicated by the line drawn on the triangle. That's why we can call it a regular triangle. So the sum of the interior angle of is of the triangle is 60 degree into 3, that is equal to 180 degree. Because as we know, the triangle which is regular is considered as equilateral triangle, and each angle of equilateral triangle is of 60 degree. That's why to find the measure of that equilateral, sum of the interior angle of that equilateral triangle, we multiply one of the angle by 3, because there are 3 angles in a triangle. So that here 60 degree is multiplied by 3, that's why we got 180. In the same way, how we use the formula to find the measure or the sum of the angle, we use the formula like this. For any polygon, okay, for any polygon, sum of interior angles is equal to n minus 2 into 180 degree. Okay, sum of interior angles is equal to n minus 2 into 180 degree, which is used to find the measure of or the sum of interior angle of any regular polygon. Where if we talk about the sum of exterior angles of a regular polygon, we have the sum of exterior angle is 360 degree.
सर चैनल बनाए थे गुड आफ्टरनून सर
So in this way, we can use the formula to find the each angle of exterior, each size of each exterior angle. We use 360 degree by n. Or in this way, we have completed the today's content.